Alright, this is one of my favorite Irish songs. It's a song called The Parting Glass, and we're gonna do a little rendition especially for you. Here we go! Drum roll for the pronunciation. Chuck Nakiba.
Excellent.
Take that. Yeah, it's good to be back in Dublin. It's been a couple of years since I last recorded here. Last time was when we were doing Leith.
That was 12, 13 years ago. Yeah.
13 years ago in the same studio. The very same studio.
Probably one of the most difficult things about recording this album was choosing the songs. There's so many amazing songs that have come out of Ireland over the last couple of years, but I really wanted the album to explore a lot of the more traditional songs. Because they're the songs that I grew up listening to. They're also the songs that throughout the years, whenever I'm away from Ireland or if I'm feeling lonely or homesick, I suppose, about Ireland, they're the songs that I always return to. So I felt to be true to myself, I'd pick songs that meant something to me on all sorts of different levels.
So maybe I'll go in with I have to listen to the part that you played at the beginning, but mm-hmm. Do you want me to go over it? Not yet.
No, I thought I was dreaming.
No, that's you.
It's your voice in my head. That's perfect. Sorry.
Black is the Colour is one of the first songs that I remember as a kid because my dad has always played it. On this album, I got to do a duet with Sharon Corr. I was a fan of the Corrs for years, still am. And to get to work with Sharon Corr and perform this song with her was just fantastic. It's a very special moment for me, and I think people are gonna love this song.
Black is the colour of my true love's hair.
Well, it has that sort of kind of very haunting, sort of mystical feel. And for me, with the violin, I just wanted to give it a sort of traditional but gypsy-like feel. You know, the Irish are really, really good at doing sort of tortured hopefulness. You know, for me, that's kind of the theme. And I think that's why it touches people, because it's the truth. There's no, like, straight emotion in life. We have, you know, there's always, like, an opposing emotion in everything that we do. And that's really perfectly portrayed in this song, you know.
Where she stays.
This is a great song called Black Velvet Band. It goes like this. In the neat little town they call Belfast, apprentice to trade, I was bound.
One of the things I discovered when I first moved over to Australia 13 years ago was the massive connection between Ireland and Australia in their music and obviously in their history. It was songs that I grew up listening to as a kid and singing as a kid that actually told stories about Irish people who were transported to Australia or Irish people who had made a brand new life in Australia and were homesick for Ireland. You know, Black Velvet Band, for instance, is a great song. That tells the story about a young fella who gets framed for stealing somebody's watch in Ireland. He gets transported to Van Diemen's Land, which is obviously Tasmania. It's one of those stories among many stories that were written about that whole transportation from Ireland to Australia, what they went through and how it even happened.
This is the crappy part about recording or being in a band. You gotta lug the gear around.
Something that's very special for me on this album is the fact that I got to perform on it with my two brothers and my sister, Paul, Darren and Anya. We toured all over Ireland when we were younger. We were in a band called Leith, and we played all these songs amongst many other songs for years. And You know, it was such an incredible time in our lives and an important time in our lives, and to now have an album that features all of us and that we were all involved in, that's a very special thing for me. And you know, there's nothing like harmonies that are created with a family. It's a very unique style, and it's a very natural style, and I think that comes through on this album as well.
I wonder, is there any other one, just while she's here, that, like Molly Malone with a harmony in that going on?
Yeah,
actually, a harmony could be nice in this. Thinking a wee harmony on Molly Malone.
Alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, flying cockles and muscles.
So many people talk to me about Irish music, and nearly always will mention a song called Molly Malone. Everyone knows Molly Malone. It's a song about a lady who sold different things throughout the streets of Dublin, and it follows her story. It's a beautiful song. It's got a lovely waltz feel to it, and we've done a special kind of newer recording. It's very true to the original feel, but we've given it just a little bit of a movement to it that I suppose gives it my own feel.
Oh, it's a celebration of life.
Galway Bay is a really special moment on the album. It is a duet with legendary Bing Crosby. And you know, as a kid growing up, I listened to everything from Bing Crosby. I was mad into Bing and all of that style of music from that entire era. And Bing had recorded a version of Galway Bay many years ago, and it actually is what made Galway Bay as famous as it is. So when we decided to record the album, we thought, wow, wouldn't it be amazing if we could try and do a duet?
On Galway Bay.
Or the breezes blowing o'er the seas from...
That moment when Bing arrives on the song, about halfway through, it's quite surreal. You hear his voice coming and you go, wow, that's Bing Crosby. And then, you know, to harmonize with him later on for the last verse, it really is. It's kind of surreal, and it's very special. And again, I think it's one of the unique elements to this whole album.
Not know.
Hey! Instant classic. See, that's what we're asking for. Instant classics.
I was very fortunate when recording this album that I got to work with some incredible musicians. Traditional musicians, people who really love this sort of music. You know, that was really important for the album. We went for that... that very rustic, very raw sound. So it is very acoustic. There's also a lot of steel guitar. There's a lot of mandolin and banjo, tin whistle, accordion. So there's a host of different musical instruments on this album, but that's all about creating a sound and being very authentic.
Ask her friend, so hair was black and her eyes were blue.
That should work.
When I woke up, I was all alone.
Galway Girl is probably the most modern song that's on the album. It was recorded and written by Steve Earle. So it's not traditionally an Irish song, but it has become a kind of a modern traditional song in Ireland. Sharon Shannon is the big connection for me with this song. She played the original accordion line on that song, and Sharon Shannon is known the world over for being probably one of the best accordion players in the world. She's amazing, and this song is a real toe-tapper. It's a good, rousing, lively tune on the album.